Hi friends, I have a video that I came up with the other day while I was sitting in my car, and I decided to just do it because I feel like this is a really interesting topic that I can actually shine a light on, and I think it's fun. So here we are. I have a condition called synesthesia. It's kind of a phenomena in which, by Google's definition of the term, meaning a neurological condition in which information meant to stimulate one of your senses stimulates other senses. So pretty much, it's kind of a crossed wire in your brain that will change the interpretation of one sense into the interpretation of another sense. In my specific example, I can see sound. So when I hear things, I can visualize what I'm hearing, even though I'm not actually seeing anything. The way that I often describe it, because I get this question a lot, is like, do you actually like see it, like in front of you? And no, I don't. It's kind of like a mind's eye type thing, where in my brain, you can give me any sound and I can tell you what color it is at the very least. I think music and people's voices are the most common things for me. Every person's voice has a different color, and I love that. I love listening to people's voices and seeing what color they sound like. And sometimes people have more than one color, and songs are the same way, where most songs are a color. I can listen to any song and I can tell you what color it is. But some songs have more than one color. And so I wanted to take this chance as a synesthete to describe to people who don't have synesthesia, or to other people who do, I don't know, what my favorite songs sound like, being the most colorful songs. So I guess the other way around. Describing the most colorful songs that I've ever heard, because there's a couple. Very, very rarely will I actually hear an entire spectrum in a song. It's a very rare thing. I believe it's only happened like 3 times ever. And so those 3 songs I want to talk to you about, and you know, show you a little bit, and also you can then see what a synesthete looks like when they're listening to music that has so much color in it. Because again, I think it's a fascinating concept. I don't know what I look like when I listen to these songs, but because of this, fun fact, I often can't listen to these songs while I'm doing important things like driving, because I will get very, very distracted by the color. It's like I'm driving on Rainbow Road, you know? And it becomes a little bit hazardous because it's hard for me to focus on the road because my mind's eye is so distracted by this rich imagery. With that said, there are 3 songs in which I have heard entire spectrums with very, very rich visuals with the synesthesia. And I wanted to kind of do a little bit of a listening session with y'all so that I can kind of describe it. This is the first song, Fellow Feeling by Porter Robinson. It's to this day is one of my favorite songs because of this. Like I said, like these aren't my favorite, like it's not a bias. Like one of these songs is by an artist that I don't really listen to that often, but I hear so much in this that I have no choice but to just love the song. So even though they're not like the best songs I've ever heard, they're so rich in color that I can't help but listen to it. So starting off with Fellow Feeling, there's this really beautiful like orchestral opening, which I could talk about the soundscaping of this song. I actually did like a whole project on it in college, but I will spare you that because I'm just talking about the colors. This is just a beautiful shimmering gold. This is what the sky sounds like. This sounds like just like almost just like the gates of heaven. Like it is very, very bright, bright blues and whites, cloudy, sunny day, with just this overtone of like a shimmering, glittery gold. And it's just beautiful. I love that. Like that's, I could listen to music like this. It's just like this all day because the actual colors of the song are just so gorgeous in and of themselves. But the reason that the song stands out to me is because of the progression and how the song completely changes. So I'll skip ahead a little bit. This is not a reaction to the song. Like, these are some of my favorite songs. I've heard them all before. I'll skip ahead a little bit here. To just before the drop. Because as the drop comes in, the song completely changes. It actually almost does a complete 180. It's the complete opposite. Where the drop being right here, hear what I hear. This is just the opposite spectrum, which is why it's so fascinating. So this is really deep, deep dark colors. This is black. This is like some flashes of like neon purple that kind of strobe through the black. And it's almost kind of scary, which is what kind of the theme of the song is. But it's a lot of like this just quick strobing flashes of like blues and purples that are shining and strobing through that complete pitch black. And I don't often hear black in a song. Black and white are colors I don't hear that often because black being the absence of color, black is technically not a color. Color theory, fun fact for you, black is not a color, it is the absence of all color. Whereas white is the presence of every color. So black and white don't happen that often. So the fact that this one begins with white, then switches to black, and then having these overtones of blue and purple, and that bright shimmering gold that is now coming back through, it's pushing back up through this white again, is just absolutely fascinating. And then in the kind of the third movement of the song here, it starts to combine both of them, where you start to hear it's black and white are kind of battling. And this is where more of the colors come in. This is just a lot of blues. This is like just a ton of different shades of blue here. But then you're getting the flashes of the bright, the purples, the neons, the black is still underneath it. And then at the drop again is where the white and the gold comes back in with the black and the blues right here. And this is where it all explodes. This is the part of the song where I hear every color that I mentioned. I'm hearing the black and the white. I'm hearing the gold, the blues, the neon purples. It's just everything at once. And the sheer amount of just the way that they mix together, they marble, and it's so amazing. But yeah, so that's Fellow Feeling. That's pretty much Fellow Feeling in a nutshell there. Again, Fellow Feeling by Porter Robinson. I think it's one of the strongest songs that I've ever heard as a synesthete. There is so much color, so much richness in it. But it's not like it's just an RGB like cycling spectrum. Like that one has very distinct, like the blacks and whites are really strong, which is what makes it super fascinating. The second song that I have is actually Light by San Holo. I feel like if San were to hear me say that I can hear the entire spectrum in the song Light, he would probably love that. I've had the pleasure of meeting San Holo a handful of times. He's one of the nicest people I've ever met, ever. And every time I see his shows, it's just the best. It's just the best. And San has a lot of color in his music. His music is very colorful. The visuals of his shows are very colorful as well. And so I would almost argue that I'm biased on this because when he plays Light at his shows, like I was at Red Rocks when he did that, and when he did his Light, like, you know, grand finale, there was just every color on, like, all of the Light shows was just every color. But I heard the song before I saw him ever play live. So that's how I know that it's not a bias, because I have always heard the entire spectrum in the drop of the song, and I'll play it for you. So I will scroll about to where the drop is. So as we're getting up in the breakdown here, again, very bright colors, a lot of blues, these are very pleasant. It's like pinks and but it's like pale. It's not like neon or anything. The build up to this is a lot of these like just blues and pinks that are just very like calming, very pleasing to look at. But this drop is where like every color is. I want it to be louder. I can't ever make this song loud enough. I think there's a reason that this song is Son's most popular song. I think it has something to do with how much color is in it. Like, it's actually hard for me to pin down what, if I had to give it one color, like what color would this song be? Sometimes they have like a dominating color. This one is just really, I feel like it's like it's just every color. It's just all of them. And there's like orange in it too. Fellow Feeling didn't have any orange. Like this one's a lot of like warm tones. There's oranges and yellows in these parts. So it's kind of that light blue, that light pink, these oranges and yellows, almost like a sunset. It's kind of, yeah, it's like a sunset or sunrise. I don't know. Is what the buildup of the song sounds like. And then the drop is just every color. It's just all of them. It's just flashes of like the whole spectrum. And it's amazing. I love it. But we have one more song that I want to talk about. This one, I saved the best for last because this song, this is the one that when I was saying that I can't drive when I listen to all of the songs, this next song, the last one that I want to talk about, I actually can't, like, I listened to it in the car the other day and I was actually struggling to drive because I was like, I was so transported to a different place by just the sounds. And for me, I don't actually listen to this artist a lot, so again, that's how you know it's not biased. This last song is called Love by Flux Pavilion, and it's like, I've heard some Flux Pavilion songs in my life. I don't dislike them. Like, I have enjoyed previous Flux Pavilion songs, but I never actually listened to them much. This song came on my Spotify once, and as soon as it came on, and I like really listened to it all the way through. It's more similar to Fellow Feeling where it's a longer song, it's more of an experience. Rather than like Light by Son Holo. It's just a colorful song. It's just fun, it's colorful, it's upbeat. This one, same with Fellow Feeling, just really just transports me to it's like an experience rather than just colors. And as a synesthete, I got to the drop of this song the first time I heard it, and I had chills in my entire body. And I don't know if this is like something that only synesthetes pick up on, or if people who just appreciate music would also appreciate, like, I genuinely don't know, because I've lived like this my whole life. And for me, I feel like the goosebumps come from seeing so many colors at once. It's just a beautiful, phenomenal thing. So I want to play this song for you. Rip copyright, but I really want you guys to hear these. I don't even care about the monetization. I just want you guys to hear these songs. This song starts off with this really mellow, like, reverby guitar. And guitar sounds to me are always in these, like, auburn caramel type colors. So this song begins with this just warm, like, autumn breeze, if I could describe a color like that. It's just warm. It's beautiful. It kind of sounds like the wind. Like, being alone with a warm breeze. Like, that's kind of what it sounds like. I mean, that's kind of what I picture, I guess. I don't really know how to describe synesthesia. But I'll skip ahead a little bit to where, this, so, as you start to get the noodling in synths, again, a lot of blue, these blues, these purples, these greens, like, they're bright colors. I feel like a lot of it has to play in with the long tone synths that are underneath it. I feel like that always contributes to hearing a lot of colors because there's a lot of chords happening underneath it, and each chord has a different color. So if you listen to every single part of this, every detail, every chord, every synth, all has a different color. I can't even put it into words. I just am like, every color, they're all there. All of them are there. And that's not even the most colorful part of the song. That's what gets me, is it's like that, you would think, like, it doesn't get more colorful than every color, right? But somehow it does. Right here, it's... I get chills. It's just so many colors. Again, it's a lot in the purples and blues and greens. It's just... Again, it's shiny. It's shiny. This song is so bright. It's bright and it's shiny and it's like space. Yeah. It's like a galaxy. This is what a galaxy sounds like. It's... So, whew. Yeah, so that's kind of the end of the song there. It starts to wind down a bit, but... If I had to find a word to describe the colors, it's like being in outer space and looking at just endless stars and galaxies of just blues and greens and purples and just all of these just beautiful bright colors and these just shining stars. That's what this song sounds like. And whenever I have the pleasure of hearing it, that's what I see. In my mind's eye, I guess. Like right in the front. It's like right in front of me, but I can tell using my very few brain cells. I can tell that it's clearly not physically in my space, but it doesn't feel like it's in my head. It feels like it's in this layer between my brain and reality. That's kind of where the synesthesia lives. I don't know if it is for other people. I haven't really had the pleasure of talking to synesthetes. So if any of you also have synesthesia, it works for other senses as well. For me, it's I can see sounds. When I hear things, I can picture them. And it makes my life a lot more colorful and a lot more beautiful. And it makes me really appreciate music. So I'm curious if other people suffer. I mean, it's not suffer because it's pretty awesome. I love having it. But if other people have the same condition, please comment and let me know. Like if you hear the same colors, because I have heard that synesthetes will hear different colors. So other people who can also hear colors, like myself, or I guess see sounds, will often see different things. So while I say that. That last song, Love by Flux Pavilion, I might say that that sounds like galaxies. Somebody else might say that that sounds like a beach, you know? Like, it's not all the same, but sometimes they do line up. So I'm curious if other people have the same condition. Do you hear the same things, or what do you hear? Is this something that interests people at all? Because I don't know. I think it's interesting. I love learning about synesthesia. Do you also have songs that you feel like would be colorful? Like I said, for me, I always feel like the most colorful songs are the songs that just have a lot in it. Like with Love, it's got a ton of chords, these really long tone chords. They're almost a little bit like they're like dissonant. And I feel like the dissonance is what really creates that kind of outer space feel of just like a lot of colors, because each note in the chord is a different color. So you put them together and there's so many colors happening. It's almost overwhelming. Like I said, like I'll get chills and I can't focus on like driving or doing anything. So I try to listen to this one when I'm, you know, just at home. I look at the time and I realize that it is currently 3 p.m., which means I have to go do a live stream, which means I'm currently 2 minutes late. But, I really want to know what people think about this. And I didn't intend for it to only be EDM, because I listen to a lot of types of music as well. So I wanted to do, like, songs of every genre, but I will admit that EDM is the most colorful music. Like, I've heard, and I'm sorry if that offends people, because I mean, don't get me wrong, I love rock music, I love all types of music. I unironically listen to jazz, I think music, I just love music. But when it comes to colors, I always feel like EDM has the most color. I don't pick what things sound like, I just see them. Don't hate the player, you know? But that's all I have for you. I hope that this was interesting because I had a great time talking about it, and I would love to do more stuff about synesthesia, maybe a Q&A or something. So if you guys want to know stuff, just freaking drop it in the comments, let me know. Please consider supporting the Patreon as well, because as you've heard today, this video will not be monetized, because the unfortunate thing about talking about music and wanting to include clips is that I will not be monetized. So if you want to consider supporting the Patreon so that I can continue to make content, that would be wonderful. You get shoutouts at the end of the videos and in the descriptions. So it's fun, it's a great time, and then my editor gets paid. Also, if you want to submit reaction songs, please do. I have a link in the description. That's, it's just a short little form that you fill out. You just tell me what song it is and give me a link to it, and then I will react to them, because I love hearing different types of music of any genre, of any type. Just let me know! And check out all my links. I guess I have a lot of links, don't I? Discord, Linktree, everything. I got it all, baby! So, check those out in the description, and let me know what you guys think, and sending love, and I will see you somewhere over the rainbow.